Assalamu alaikum children. This is Islamic studies class for the grade 4. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbi zidni ilma. Rabbi zidni ilma. Allahumma faqihna fid din. Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafian wa rizqan tayyiban wa amalan mutaqabbalan. Allahumma anfa'na bima 'allamtana wa 'allimna ma yanfa'una wa zidna 'ilma. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Now children, today we will continue our unit 6, Life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, part 1. In the previous video, we have seen the condition of Arabs. Then Allah had mercy on them and He sent His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam appointed as the messenger of Allah, then he invited the people towards Islam, and the people became angry and hostile because Islam, it was against their beliefs and customs. Then we have seen the migration to Abyssinia. These people were abusing to Muslims, so the Muslims decided to migrate to Abyssinia, where the king was Najashi. So he was a kind king and he gave shelter to them. Then some of the disbelievers came to Najashi and they asked him to send these Muslims back, but Najashi did not return. When he heard the recitation of Quran from Hazrat Jafar radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he recited Surah Maryam. Then King Najashi was not ready to send them back. Then we have seen social boycott when these Muslims started living in the Shebe Abi Talib, where they lived for 3 years with social boycott, with no food and other allowances. Okay, now we will continue this lesson with the year of sorrow. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam declared the 10th year of his revelation as the year of sorrow because his beloved wife Khadija radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu and uncle Abu Talib died in this year. So why this year was known as the year of sorrow? Because his uncle Abu Talib and his beloved wife Khadija radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu, they died in this year. That's why this year was known as the year of sorrow. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam deeply felt these two incidents. Okay, so it was very difficult to bear this situation for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam when his two beloved relatives or two beloved relations, they separated from him. Hazrat Khadija radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu and Hazrat Abu Talib, his uncle. Okay, now we'll see the journey of Taif. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to a nearby city of Taif to preach Islam. Now when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to invite the people towards the Islam openly, so he started visiting the other cities. Like he went to Taif to preach Islam. Not only the people of Taif refused to listen to him, but they also encouraged some mischievous people to hurt him. These people of Taif, they did not accept Islam. They did not support to Islam, but they encouraged some mischievous people to hurt Prophet. These people pelted stone at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and drove him out of the town. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was badly injured. Allah sent angel Jibril alaihi salam. He asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to let him punish the people of Taif. He refused and instead prayed for them. So here you can see the Mount Taif. The mountain which is there in Taif, where Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam visited, and the people refused. Now we will see the night journey. One night when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was resting at the house of Umme Hani radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu, angel Jibril alaihi salam appeared. He invited him for a divine journey. He accompanied a white winged animal called Buraq. First of all, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Al-Aqsa Mosque, Masjid Al-Aqsa in Jerusalem, where he met other prophets and they all prayed behind him. Then angel Jibril alaihi salam took the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the heavens. He visited seven heavens one by one. So here the picture of Masjid al-Aqsa in Jerusalem. So here Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam he offered prayer with all the prophets. From there the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went on until he came under the divine light of Allah. He talked to Allah, and during this conversation Allah ordered the Muslims to pray 5 times daily. After all that happenings, he was brought back to his bed. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was surprised to find that the bed was still warm. The whole journey took a few moments. This journey in Islamic history is known as Al-Miraj, means ascension. It was real bodily one. It was a real bodily one. The migration to Medina. Now, after living in the Makkah for 10 years, now Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he migrated to Medina. As people of Makkah were abusing them, or they were not accepting what is true religion, Islam. The unbelievers of Makkah were furious at the growth of Islam. The followers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam were increasing day by day. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to preach Islam during the Hajj, when many tribes of Arab would come. On one such occasion, a few people of Medina accepted Islam. They belonged to 2 main tribes of Medina, Aus and Khazraj. With them, Islam reached Medina. So during the Hajj, when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was preaching Islam, here the people of Medina, they accepted. So these people actually went to Medina and they spread Islam over there. Slowly the 2 tribes became Muslims. They loved the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam very much. They requested Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to leave the hostile Makkah and come with them. He accepted their invitation. He instructed the Muslims to migrate to Medina in small groups. He himself waited for Allah's permission to migrate to Medina. When the unbelievers of Makkah heard that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted to migrate, they decided to kill him. They surrounded the house of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah gave the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam permission to migrate to Medina. He lay his cousin Hazrat Ali radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu at his bed and went to the house of Abu Bakr radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Interestingly, no unbeliever saw him going, although they were right in front of him. The unbelievers became irritated when they found that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has escaped. They announced a big reward on his head. Many unbelievers ran in all directions to catch or kill him, but failed. So after leaving Makkah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam